Cranial nerve 9, or the glossopharyngeal nerve, is one of the more complicated of the cranial nerves because it has so many different components. It has a motor component, which is both somatic and visceral, so it goes to skeletal muscle and smooth muscle. It also, or a gland, actually in this case it's a gland, and it has multiple sensory modalities. It has somatic sensory, special sensory, and visceral sensory. And you can see in this image from the posterior aspect of the pharynx, here is the glossopharyngeal nerve, right here and right here. And it's lying along the only muscle that it innervates, which is the stylopharyngeus muscle, here and here. So the motor component of the glossopharyngeal nerve, again, it's going to innervate the stylopharyngeus muscle right here. And that is the key to finding this muscle if you're ever doing a dissection, is that you're always looking for the glossopharyngeal to lie right along that muscle. The rest of this muscle, if you'll recall, if you have not yet watched the lecture on the vagus nerve, this is all of the skeletal muscle that forms the upper part of your pharyngeal constrictors. It's continuous with the esophagus, and it's all innervated by the vagus. There's a visceral or parasympathetic component of the glossopharyngeal nerve, and it innervates the parotid gland. So when we talked about cranial nerve 7 and its autonomic functions, its cranial nerve 7 innervates the sublingual and the submandibular glands, even though it goes right by the parotid gland, it doesn't innervate them. The glossopharyngeal, via jumping over on a couple of other nerves to get to its target, is what innervates the parotid gland. When it comes to sensation, the glossopharyngeal is also, again, it's complicated. So the somatic part of the somatic innervation, or the somatic modalities carried by the glossopharyngeal, are from the posterior or post-sulcal portion of the tongue. So it's this part. And so remember that 5 is general sensory for the front of the tongue, and so N9 is general sensory for the posterior part of the tongue. It also innervates part of your external ear and the internal surface of your tympanic membrane. So if you have an earache, if there's fluid in the ear and it causes pressure, that modality, that sensation is going to be transmitted by the glossopharyngeal nerve. There's a special component, a special sensory, and that is taste. And again, that's going to be for this posterior, post-sulcal part of the tongue. So the posterior one-third, taste is cranial nerve 9. And remember that taste for the anterior portion is 7. There's also a special sensory part, and I put in this image down here. This is your carotid artery, here and here. And it splits into an internal and an external component. The external carotid artery, as you know, is the blood supply to your face. And the internal carotid artery contributes a huge portion of the circulation to the brain. Where it bifurcates, this carotid bifurcation contains two very special sensory apparatuses, or apparati. They're the carotid body and the carotid sinus. These are sensory organs that measure your blood pressure and your CO2 concentration. That visceral information about blood pressure and CO2 concentration are carried back to your brainstem by the glossopharyngeal nerve. In the next segment, we'll talk about the hypoglossal nerve and the muscles that it innervates.